Welcome back, everybody. It is another episode of Sandrici's Super Sadistic Sandbox. Let me turn this down. A little loud in the old ears. Turn it down with my headset. So, last time we upgraded most of the remaining items that I really wanted to. So all that's really left is to turn that one log wall stone, and then I want to build like funnels into the traps so that they don't like come through the corners and they come straight headlong into the traps. So I think that's what's on the agenda. Something. Be closer than that. Even a little closer. Yeah, like that. Now if somebody tries to come in here, they're gonna get hit. I can probably go a skosh closer. Like that. It's a little close. I gotta be sure that it doesn't touch. Comfortable with that. I think I just heard enemies. I don't know if that was a deer or a cannibal. Now I heard a cannibal. Oh. Kind of dangerous. Here, you do it. Seems risky. Maybe I don't need to do that. I'm just maybe here though. Huh? Yeah, see that I like a lot. Where should I put the cross? Forgot about that. Oh. Sorry, bro. Ah, great. I can't believe he got to me. He took a lot of my armor. Whatever shall I do? Here, I think what I want is like yeah, that looks okay. All right, so yeah. What? We'll just get these. first layers down because it might be prudent to put some spikes on them. And they do seem to attack this side the most, this side the second most. So I kind of want to concentrate our efforts there. What is setting that thing off? What we'll do is we'll make sure that this one fits. That work? Oh, it's gonna be close. I'm a little scared it's gonna rub, so. That looks perfect. Tell me, Calvin is a beast. That should funnel him into there, you know? I wonder if it'll let me put a second layer before the first layer is ever done. Like they probably, as long as they can't walk through there, I could even put a defense post or something if I had to. Here's one that they desperately need. So I've seen them get stuck in this spot before. Atta boy. Seems odd, kind of in that corner there, but I still think it's what I want. What the hell are those? Geese? Fill up that sled. Well, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run down. Let's get a quick save. Just run to our little camp down here. Oh, this is where Kelvin was coming to get his stones. That's not too bad then, because this is a good supply for him. Maybe I should just let him do that. What I'll do. So I will dump this water off. Go get more. I super need to build more shelves. That's nice, actually. Yeah. That's only a million times better. throwing my spare logs in there for now, if you know what I mean. This actually isn't too bad now. That's kind of like my secret way down. If I closed in the rest of these, I actually think this area might be warm. Because that might even count as warm. And so would that. It's just that one, probably. It's just a hunch. Sorry about that distraction. Is that a mutant? So I don't think that cross light like renders super far. So I think if I put it up on that tower, I won't see it. So let's try building it here. We'll come back to it. Actually. So I don't think I have the logs. What does it need again? Just one log. There we go. Have ourselves a forest barbecue. Good food. All right, shall we? Yeah, I don't want to build in the dark, so. Save 160, unreal. Alrighty. See, I'm convinced building these walls will make a huge difference on, like, the trap effect. What's she bringing me? Nothing. Oh, look at all these stones from Kelv. I actually want them to still be able to come through, though. Absolutely. That's the one I want. It's all the way up there. Oh my God. Hey. Finally getting some decent raids. See, when these walls are done, he's not going to have those luxuries. They're going to have to walk straight into them, not be able to cross them like that. Nonetheless, we're about full up on creepy again. Start storing my bones too. Not that I really want to make bone armor, but do something with the ones that get caught in the fire traps. I won't burn the others, I'll just take the fire trap bones. We'll still have so many. Yeah. Yeah. She must have heard me. Did you hear that? I swear I just said the same thing. This is the part in the video where I would probably fast forward, put it in that fast, you know, that 150% speed. Because I'm going to be running some spikes for a little while. You can't do this in the winter. Wonder if electric fences would be good for what I'm doing right now. I just honestly, I don't think I have the wire. 27. I would use up like, you know, 20 just on the these two corners. So, nope, not gonna do that. We're gonna save it for lights and stuff. Oh no. Well, you just get to see a classic crash. I feel like we saved not too long ago, though. Unfortunate, nonetheless. It was like 8 minutes ago. You can do about it. Maybe it correlates to me having the video software running, but that's the only thing I can think. It says my CPU is being used 0.1% though. Oh, I saved right after the water. Excellent. I didn't lose much at all. I should have jumped to the other one. What am I doing? So we're going to take this free stuff because I didn't. I didn't ask for the crash, you know? Oh, we forgot the water. What did we lose exactly? We lost all of our sticks. we're going to be picking logs from here anymore. I did think I had a stick holder there here, though. Get all those into an inventory. Really. Oh, they broke the log. Good thinking. Get our mutant armor. I bet you that's a baby. Come on. Okay. Think what I will do. Where was that other stone holder? Here. I don't know if I can reach it from up top. I lost 2 zip lines off that operation. I should have just made that thing out of stone. Let's do that. Sorry, Virginia. Whew. Can't go higher, right? Nice. There we go. Alright, let's get a few sticks into this thing. Give these stone holders on each corner, it'll give Kelvin the ability to fill like each side. So I think the only place I still need one is really off of like this corner. So I will throw one here. Like here. Nice. And we have the venerable sled. It's probably fine to be here. Let's go get some ropes. We've really got a way to get up to that thing. It is ridiculous that we haven't solved that problem yet. I mean, that's the other thing we could do now, of course, instead of this whole stone thing that we're doing. It's fun to switch it up, you know, but it'd probably make more sense to get one project complete and then move on. So what we need to do is wrap this thing in stone, too, so that it's safe to build. Let's throw a few logs into it, though. I say never attack it if I'm not, like, right next to it. Could just wrap it in logs too temporarily. I remember we got ropes now. What do I hear? Did someone really attack me? I thought I heard an enemy. At this point in the game, it's like it's like disbelief that somebody would attack. Like, really? Did they not see the defenses? Thing is, though, I'm getting the initial placements done, and this is where I kind of have to like measure and eye stuff up. And this will all be over in a not much time to fill this. Hello, sir. Wow. Freaking annoying. See why we need the walls? He can only do that because he's able to walk sideways through them. If he had to walk straight through them, that one's gonna be close. We might have to tweak, but I think I need to finish. All right. Yeah, see, that's probably gonna hit that wall. And so we just need to move it out like a skosh. Or we just do yeah, this is a better move, honestly. Ropes. It should keep the deer from running like sideways and setting off 50 of them too, you know? It's gonna be so important. So I want this one to be kind of extra long for deer thwarting reasons. Okay, that's max distance anyway. That's right what I was thinking. And I would love to see the one on this side. I think that's good, man. I can see daylight. Right? Alright, so three ropes just fell out of it, right? Where are they? Somehow two fall into the ground. You see what I mean? There's one. It's shitty, though. I can't get up this way, right? Let's try. Even if we fall. Oh no, we can. Okay. Alrighty. We're getting the ropes. Was that? Oh. I'm stuck. Alrighty. Good. Yeah, that's pretty good. Pretty good. So I probably do want these to come out even further, but on this side it goes out as far as the traps, plus one more. So yeah, we'll do plus one more. Right now, we'll just do the end ones, the endmost ones. And those, of course, are the most important to do first to funnel everything into the traps. Is that what we'll call these? These are our funnel walls. Really, it should get one here too. I saw him. Now, I haven't done any in this section in the back yet. Back here, I don't want to block it completely, so not sure what we're going to do with that. See, if then it looks like forces them like right up against the wall. I guess that makes like a maze where they would want to do this. I don't know. Maybe we'll build one in there in the middle and see what it's like. Some to either go through this little gap, which you can do, and then they try to come in, they're annihilated. Then I could build another little wall right here. Yeah, I guess that's the move. Not there, but here. I'm afraid this one's going to hit the walls, and it's also not perfectly straight. Whereas the other ones, I think, are all perfect placements. I don't care, I'm drinking the dirty water. think what we'll do is we'll move this. And this. That's a little too close, right? That looks like it. Is it off the wall enough? Right. They should give me some ammo in here. Sir. Oop. Let's put these last stones in place. These traps are okay for now. Yeah, you can see, like, that's the ideal distance in between. It's like a quarter log in between the poles. Mm-hmm. Just like that. If they come in, it's just a absolute death sentence in there. I could probably put, but yeah, I mean, I can force them so they've got to go through doubles into here. Yeah, I'm telling you, when these walls are in, this thing is going to be ridiculous. You won't see one guy come in and set them all off anymore. One guy's going to come in and set off two. And if anybody follows him, they'll all be dead. Just like the entrance to my other base. I basically have built, you know, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 entrances per side. And they're all going to be killing machines. I might even be able to get 2, you know, like a whole second one out in front. I think I will. It'll just be a matter of, I might have to splice in the walls if it's not perfectly flat enough. All right, that's probably a good point for the episode. Let's go in here and start cooking some stuff. we have? Guess let's just drink it. Now from here. I do wish I could get to the water right from the spot. I guess. Yeah, that's the move. Easy peasy. Man, I can't see. See, here I probably want to put electric lights soon, so I'm just going to live with it. Eventually we'll have to get some more lights out in the yard so we can see what's happening out there in a circle all around. But we'll be able to put lights on these stone walls we're building, for one. All that cooked meat. I'll tell you what, we will go and we're going to put a couple of these cooked meats on a shelf by themselves and see if they rot and how long they take to rot. So we'll put them on this bottom shelf and we'll try our best not to eat them. Two cooked meats. We'll see if they rot. Eat this one. Go ahead and eat one of these so we have nice full stats when we come in. Look at that. Alrighty, so we'll go up here. We'll take a look from above what our little progress is for this episode. It's going to seem minimal, but we got all those placements done, if you know what I mean. So now we can see that's where the stone walls will be on every side. Oops. I mean, honestly, that's a pretty good picture. of what we're doing. Always kind of like to sum it up at the end, you know? I think that'll make a pretty good little maze or when they come into the back, the section. It's going to be, they're really going to be bottled in, so I won't have to worry about them breaking the pillars because it's going to be like in the strongest spot protected with traps all around. So all in good time. Like eventually I might make it where they can't get down into this space at all is kind of what I'm thinking. Like this wall continue almost all the way to here, if not all the way. Same thing from here over to here. And that way they might be able to, you know, they'll never be able to even break to this thing. But either way, it wouldn't be that hard to rebuild even if they did break a piece of that. So all right, we'll call it there. And we will see you guys on the next one. Peace.